On October 28, local time in Switzerland, the WTO selection committee recommended Nigerian candidate and former Nigerian Minister of Finance, Dr. Ngozi, to the General Council as the new Director General.
One delegation could not support.
Wait, what? Who?
That delegation was the United States of America.
Hello everyone, this is Happy. Just at the end of selection, a surprise struck. The US became the only country among 164 countries that implicitly opposed Dr. Ngozi as the Director General, citing her lack of experience. In fact, Dr. Ngozi served the World Bank for 25 years and once was the Managing Director of the World Bank. She also served as Minister of Finance of Nigeria. Obviously, the reason of lack of experience is untenable. Not only can the reason for objection be scrutinized, but the timing of the US opposition has also been criticized by many people. The Wall Street Journal quoted a representative of the EU as saying, if the US had any issue, it should be raised far earlier. Deliberately declared opposition at the last minute also reflects US government's hegemonic and American exception behavior in dealing with international agreements over the years. Those who follow me prosper, those who oppose me perish. William Renish, currently a senior advisor at the Center of Strategic and International Studies, said that the US opposition was likely to worsen trade tension already running high within the WTO. He also added, the US move is basically saying, we want to get our way and we are ready to throw sand in the gears if we don't get it. The US public defiance will also disrupt the pace of WTO. CNN reported that the White House has repeatedly criticized WTO and undermined its mission by constantly imposing tariffs and even blocked the appointment of key positions in the WTO, which hobbled the operation of WTO. At present, WTO has set November 9th as a deadline. If a consensus is still not reached by then, the use of voting to resolve a deadlock is not an out. According to Politico, that vote is equivalent to a nuclear option in WTO and will explode WTO's longstanding preference of resolving disputes through negotiations. This is not the first time that the USA has disrupted the work pace of the WTO. In September last year, Trump threatened that if the WTO did not reform, the US would withdraw from the organization. In this year, February, Trump would reveal that he was considering withdrawal from the WTO agreement on government procurement. Keep Yang withdrawal now intervening in the selection of the Director General. After all, Washington doesn't really care who gets the position. They just want that everything is under their control. To be such one only, Washington seems to be determined to go on the road as an international orphan. This is my opinion. See you next time.